Here we go.
Outrageous!
Hello, my name is John, and I love to talk movies, comics, anime, and I may have reviews, rankings, reactions, whatever, coming out in the future. So if you love nerd culture, consider clicking that subscribe button. And for today's review, we have Netflix's new anime original series, Dragon's Dogma. It is based off of Capcom video games, of which I am unfamiliar with. So I'm kind of going in a little blind based off of that, but I did watch trailers and everything. And so I guess let's get started. Dragon's Dogma is 7 episodes, and each episode is both titled and themed after one of the 7 deadly sins. And so I think that theme, what they were going for, I like the idea, but I also think the 7 deadly sins aspect is kind of what hurt it the most. It felt forced from my perspective, because outside of 2 or 3 episodes, it felt like it was full of filler almost. You know, the premiere, the penultimate, and the finale felt necessary, but outside of that, the other 4 episodes, they just felt unnecessary, fillery. The only purpose was to serve 1 monologue in the finale. And they kind of depart a little too much from the main story. And so I think that, along with another aspect that wasn't too great in this anime, was the character development. Ethan, the main character, has some pretty good development and he has a decent story. But I do think he doesn't get development in necessarily every episode. And that kind of is what makes it feel dragged out. It makes it feel like it departs a little too much in some of the middle section. But I think overall his story is fine. His development's decent enough. But I think Hannah, the other kind of main character, the character that's in like every episode, doesn't have any development at all. She just kind of shows up with magical powers and that's all we know about her. And so I think that hurt the finale. Even though I loved the finale, it made the payoff at the end a little lackluster. That lack of development just didn't help with the payoff of the finale of the show. And then the story as a whole, you've seen it before. It's just kind of like a typical fantasy-esque revenge story. And it's just kind of very forgettable. But to talk about something a lot more positive about the show, the action is very fun. It's great spectacle action that you love to see in an anime like this. And so I do think that saves it a lot, because you watch an anime like this for the action, and so you'll get what you came for. And so I think that helps the enjoyment level go up a lot more. And so I guess to move on to the rating, this is a very short review, but moving on to the rating, the premiere and the finale are great. And the middle section has some fun action, some great spectacle action in it. And the story isn't horrible. It's forgettable, but it's not bad. It's not horrible. And so I think if you can get past the fillery aspects of that middle section, and even the animation style itself, it takes a little getting used to. But I think if you can get past the animation style also, and the fillery aspects of the middle section, you'll enjoy the show for the most part. It's pretty average. And so I think for the score, it deserves basically an average score right down the middle. So I think a 2.5 is a fair score to give Dragon's Dogma. Thanks for watching my video. If you've seen Dragon's Dogma, consider commenting your thoughts down below. If you like this video, if you liked me, consider hitting that thumbs up, and also consider clicking that subscribe button if you enjoy movies, comics, and anime as I do. And as always, have a great day.